The track was fresh. That meant the car sunk down just a little while ago. Now, where the hell could the passengers possibly have gone? Someone had been playing with a crossbow here. A very dangerous game. A bolt could hit someone's tire, or their eye. It could even kill someone if the aim was right. Someone must have dropped this in a hurry, but whoever did was heading into the woods. Carl's tracking instincts were quickly kicking in. Engulfed by a wave of cold, and for a second thought he was fainting. All of a sudden, four phantasmagoric figures were fixing their gaze on him. What the hell was going on? Sensed that the cold was beating a retreat, as if he was moving away from some kind of center of gravity. Carl knew why he was suddenly shivering. He was going back to the realm of visions. The further Carl moved away from the ice block, the more his senses came back to him. Thank you. was only void where the road should be. Carl hated dead ends. He felt trapped. It was as if the road had drowned in the lake. He would have to find help by another road. It was so cold. Already Carl did not feel his toes anymore. Giving way to awareness. The vision was wavering. Cold turned into pain. Carl needed to find someplace warm. A wintry atmosphere surrounded the house. The soundlessness of the area suggested it was empty. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot. The key, which seemed to be meant for a padlock, bore an inscription reading Clouté et Fils. A company name. Better keep an eye open. Businesses weren't exactly numerous around these parts. The spirograph amused Carl. It was a nice modern toy. Aside from being repetitive by nature and completely useless, still, it found its way into many Quebecois homes. Money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. Hay stub for some undoubtedly harsh lumberjack work. Alexandre Blais felled trees and chopped woods for Cloutier et Fils. The picture had been taken inside the house. It was the same wallpaper. Judging by the smiles, nobody suspected the impending misfortunes. Little Martin Blais with a family member. There was some resemblance between them, and Carl took note of the sense of bonding and pride they projected. The sheets were in such a way that indicated a rude awakening, followed by a hurried escape. What had happened here? Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. money in a jar. What a shame. Carl would have loved cookies. Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. Carl's big fingers prevented him from reaching the key. When finding a boot, one wonders what became of the foot.